Hi there, I'm Alex Berg, and I'm joined by Dave from Feedback Gaming. Say hi, Dave.
Hi Dave, hi Alex, hi everyone, hi the comments, hi YouTube,
Oh
hello
my,
internet.
so many highs. Anyway, what were we doing? We were playing this Crusader Kings thing, and we're going to make you the king.
Yeah, so we've picked a physician. I've got a message saying a message about your request council support has been received from Richard Devassy. Oh, I've got loads of messages that's popped up.
Okay, I'll pause the game and let you deal with
Okay, so the Court of York has rejected the Institute of the Ruler Imprisonment Sovereignty Law. Oh, that was the law that I tried to change, wasn't it?
Yeah, the council don't like you, man.
Wow.
Yep.
Okay.
But I can try as I might and
How do I
see.
know who voted against me? Can I kill them?
The thing is, if you want to control your council, go to the council tab, that's the F3, and take a look at my council. And here you can see, do any of them have like a checkered border around their status icon? That was very, very hard to.
It's kind of hard to make out.
Yeah, okay. You see, Osulf, your steward, he has a heart, right? Yeah, and then there are two guys who have prayer icons and two guys with stars, yeah? Any of them have any red borders around their icons?
The one at the bottom left is the one with the Viking helmet,
Yeah. That
Marshall.
means if you mouse over it, somebody's bought him out. Somebody's actually paying him to vote with them.
Right.
Yeah, so he's part of a conspiracy to keep you out of power. What you want to.
Whoa, I don't like him.
No, we don't. You can just fire him from your council. That's always an option. So you can just replace him with someone else. Also, what you can do for other councillors is you can right-click on them and then you can request council support, or you can buy a favor. If the
Request
problem with the
council
request council
support.
support is that will give them a favor, which they can turn around and use to make you institute some sort of change to the council. So it's a kind of a fucked up mechanic. The best way to do it is to buy a favor off them straight up and then use that favor, leverage that favor to get them to support you in the council. This is the most sort of intricate and weird mechanic that's in the game. And it's one of these mini games where they've tried to make the peacetime interesting, and I think they kind of failed, but a lot of people like it. I just don't. That's why I like to neuter the council and just make sure they can't do anything, but that's just me. Anyway, what you want to do is you want to request council support from at least two other members. If you get two people to support you, then I will be the third one and you will be the fourth vote, and then we'll pass anything you want.
So these are the people that are in my positions, aren't they?
Yep.
Oh well, I would have really thought that these guys would have been on my back all the time.
Yeah, they kind of like you, but they like their own power base too.
So they've all got their own agenda, haven't they?
Yes, they do. And they
Oh
don't.
my God, this is not very nice. That's
No,
not very nice.
this is what it's like to be a ruler. People have their own reasons for liking and supporting you.
Okay, so what do I do then? So I'll go for the spy master and I'll ask plot to kill. No, what do I
You
do?
right-click on them and you take Request Council Support.
Request council support. Yeah, and it says the Bishop Wolf of St. Peter's accepts your request. He will vote as you do on the council for 36 months, and oh, you owe him a favor. What is a favor then?
Okay, a favor is a form of currency where he can turn around and request you do something for him. Like, for instance, institute a law, make him a counselor, allow him to marry some twat. Stuff like that.
Okay, so I'm gonna right click on the count chaplain. Request council support. Yes. So I've given two. How come you're not on this list anymore? I thought you were in this list.
I'm supposed to be there.
One, two, three. No, you're not there anymore. Oh yeah, you are. Have you shaved your beard?
Yes, I shaved my head and my beard.
Are you actually joking me, or have you actually shaved?
I shaved.
Oh wow!
There's a button for it. I'll show you.
Really?
Yes.
You really threw me off. Okay, so we've got 3 out of 5. So can I do the vote again now?
Yeah, not for another something months, though.
Oh, okay. So your wife, Duchess Rocker, has sent you a gift. It is a small puppy, but of the finest pedigree, a destined to grow into a great hunting dog. I will accept this generous gift, send it back, or pay someone to quietly dispose of
Trust me, you want the dog. It gives you +1 health and it gives you great events. You want the dog.
Why would you do the bomb one? Why would you pay someone to get rid of the dog?
If you're a cruel and evil person and you hate your wife, then maybe you would do that.
I suppose so,
Or
yeah.
if you're a
And
lunatic.
there's any bit of chance that she'll be insulted.
If you want your wife to
Okay.
hate you for some reason because you want her to try to plot against you so that you can throw her in jail and kill her and get her titles, that might be a
Your
reason.
puppy has no name yet, my lord. What shall we call it? Faithful, Hunter, or Tricky?
Aww.
I'll call it Tricky.
Tricky!
There's a magnificent Duke of Morcar. Ooh, magnificent. I like that title. May you live in harmony and contentment. Whoa, hang on a second. Got more pops I can handle right now.
Shit, we're at
Oh,
war.
something just happened. Holy shit. Panic, panic. Let me finish this message.
Shit, we're at war with France.
Please summon me by voting with me in the council. If you agree to do this for me, I will
Owe you a
henceforth
favor.
owe you a favor.
Yes, there you go.
You
He's
live in harmony.
doing the exact same thing that you did to your counselors.
Oh, is this the favor for the favor thing then?
Yeah, he wants you to support him in the council, and he'll owe you a favor for it. And having the King of England owe you a favor is not pointless. However, he did just go to war, you know?
My liege, blessings upon you and your house. I will support you in the council. Great. Oh, that was the response. Okay. So what just happened?
We're at war.
With who?
France.
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 Okay. Do I have to do anything?
Not really, unless you want to.
What would I do?
Well, I don't get this. Why are we at war over m shit, the English declared on us.
The English declare war or not? Oh, so what do you mean, us?
Well, no, sorry, the French declared war on the English for Maine in France.
Oh, that
France.
county, yeah.
Yeah. Now, I suggest we just don't give a damn. I
So,
don't
is
think
this
the AI
really.
will be able to defend this anyway.
This is
We'll
a
see.
comm stomp. It's AI versus AI.
Yep, we'll just leave the computer to fight. Now you can see him moving his armies around, though.
Peace be with you. I will support you in the council. Oh, that was the other request. Okay.
Yep. Now you can see how long it is until you can change one of the council laws and stuff like that.
Oh, yeah, good point. Yes. It's under laws, council. I'll hover over. It says the 5th of February in 1077, so 10 years. So that favor
Yeah.
was useless because it was only there for 36 months.
Yeah, but it'll stop them from doing shit for 36 months because the other councillors can introduce bills and stuff like that too.
Okay.
So
So this.
it'll keep them nice and quiet.
This icon in the bottom right, King Philip of France. So this is who we're at war with, right? That means an existing war that. Yeah?
Hang on. What did you just say?
The bottom right, you've got the little circle icon next to the map. That's a war that we're currently in. Is that what that means? English,
Yeah,
French,
that.
English, du jour, War of Maine. Okay, yeah.
So right now it's 0-0 and only two combatants. It's King Philippe of France
Philip's a little.
versus King William the Conqueror.
King Philip is a little baby.
Yep, he's 15.
He's a babby.
He's gonna be mature in 1 year.
So are they? So the everyone's. So I guess that the king's called everyone's levies, right?
Yeah, so
Are they
he's.
called our levies?
Yes, they're standing in York, 1,800 men right now.
Yeah, I can see. Are they
The
gonna
army of
go?
Mayor Adam.
The army of Mayor Adam.
Yep.
Okay.
So that's a thing.
Do we? So we don't get to control them, right?
Nope.
Okay. Unless, well, unless we called them.
Yep. Oh, look, he's put them on boats and everything. Wow. Go AI!
Yeah, AI too strong. Please nerf.
And oh, my wife is pregnant. Woohoo!
I'll let you know if I get messy. I don't think I had. He says at the top, one character owes you a favor.
Yep. That's the King of England. He owes you a favor.
I don't know what's happened, but I've realized there is actually no game audio for me. 1 minute.
Okay.
Yeah, there's no game audio. We're going to have no audio for this episode. Okay, never mind. She's going to have to listen to our sweet voices.
What just happened? Why? Oh, right. There might be something happening in Scotland.
Oh. How do you know?
Well, it's just some little bird told me. There's this thing where...
You know too much. It scares me.
Oh, there's the British army in... Oops! Well, the mercenaries ambushed the carriage of King Malcolm III, making short work of him. Unfortunately, the driver survived and saw through their disguises. My involvement is now public knowledge. Good, but bad.
You're involving what?
Well, there's a new king in Scotland, let's put it that way, and he's 7 years old, so I thought it might be easier for us if we want to take the Cumberland thing, if there's a kid in charge.
What were you trying to do?
I was just trying to weaken Scotland so we can kill him.
Oh, we killed a kid?
No, I killed his father.
Oh, he's dead?
Yeah, I assassinated the King of Scotland. Murdered on the order of Count Ulsef of Northumberland on July 4th, 1067.
You got discovered, though.
Yeah.
That's really bad, isn't it?
Well, what's he going to do? Invade me?
Well, we guess he could right now. This is a really ample opportunity. We're all fighting in France.
No, we're not.
Well, technically we are, because our levies are there, so we won't be able to raise any levies, would we?
Yes, we still have our personal levies. We have sent the part of our levies that are reserved for our liege, they have been sent to France to die. But our own levies are intact.
So there's two kinds, then?
Yes. If we wanted to, we could send 4,000 men or 3,000 men to help William in France. We're not going to do that, though.
Right. Okay. I've got a few messages. Let me go through these messages. So, your dog is growing quickly and no longer is a puppy. He runs fast and has a keen eye. Keen nose. Not eye, no. Keen nose. And your dog handlers praise his good character. Good dog. 10 prestige. Oh, wow. That was nice. My liege, my mission to Rome has far been success. During my visit, the court pope, Alexander II, I seem to have managed to make him understand what a benevolent and pompous ruler you really are, and he sends his regards. Porpoise? What's porpoise?
Basically, competent.
Right. Your humble court chaplain, Prince Bishop something of Durham. Civilizations. He can unpause.
So the Pope, the Mr. Pope man likes you. That's good.
I love the Pope. He's got great powers and he can fly, right?
Yes, the Pope can fly.
Oh no, we're being invaded!
Shit! What's this? These are raiders.
Oh, raiders?
Yeah, they're raiders. As long as they're not in York, I don't see why we should care.
I don't really understand. Raiders? Well,
yeah, these are Vikings.
Oh.
They're there to rape, pillage, burn, and plunder, and not necessarily in that order.
Are they taking advantage of the fact that they know we're at war? Is that the way they've landed?
I think the AI will check to see if you can raise armies. But then again, raiders have a tendency to show up anyway. But right now, there is nothing our king can do about it.
Are these your kin? Are these Norwegians?
Let's see. They are from Medlapad, which is in Sweden. So, no.
Damn you, Paradox.
These are Swedes. Yeah, all of them are Swedes. So no, I don't feel any kinship to them. The Norwegians at this stage of the game are Christians, so they don't raid.
Normandy's right. Normandy. What's the deal with those cities? They've got lots of smog. Green smog.
Yeah, there is this. If you press Evora or Murta, and you look in the bottom left corner, you can see there's a small icon that looks like a guy with some bubbles coming out of his head. If you press Evora or Murta.
Yeah, I've clicked on it. Yeah.
Yeah, right over the big golden bar, you can see there's a red icon with a little head on it.
No.
No?
So I click on it and it brings up that little the rectangle on the left, right?
Yeah.
And you've got the name of the counts. You've got.
Yeah, so you got the little portrait and then the castle, right?
Yeah.
Right below the castle, there's a green bar and a red bar, and then right below there's
there we go. There
slow
we go.
Fever. It's basically typhoid. Typhus. Typhoid. Yeah, typhoid.
Typhoid, yeah.
So, not horribly deadly, but not nice.
You've got a choice. You've got influenza as a factor to your county. Do you spend five administration, or do you contain the province? You know what I'm talking about, right?
Say again?
It was in EU4. It was the most.
Oh yeah. Ever. The influenza thing, yeah.
Yeah, it's like you spend five admin to try and stop it spreading, or do you contain the province?
Yep.
He never contained.
You should always try to contain that shit. And now Västerbotten is here too. Now the northern Swedes are there.
An epidemic has threatened your court. You can shut the gates. Characters of Succession will still have a hard time communicating with the outside world, but should avoid infection from outside sources.
Yeah, we don't have to shut the gates. As long as it doesn't spread to York, it doesn't matter.
Is it the typhoid? Is that what he's referring to?
It's basically there is a disease in our realm, because we're part of the English realm, so we have the option of shutting the gates.
Okay.
Keep everybody out until the sickness goes away.
There's bigger fish to fry. We're at war. We've got like tons of Vikings.
Well, York is peaceful. I don't know what the rest of the world's doing, but we're fine. We're trying to kill the king of Scotland.
That's not a good worldview, is it? We're looking after ourselves and nobody else.
Yep. Looking out for number one.
Okay, so dear Morka, I would like to invite you to join for a small gathering of friends to dine and drink and forget about the world outside for a little while. Please be prepared to reserve a few for this. You might want to pause. For this. In case you get truly into the spirit of proceedings, yours, Count Gerhard of Chester. Of course I will come. Unfortunately, I can't. What's he inviting me to?
Party.
Okay, I guess I say yes, right?
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
It's important to party.
I guess if the typhoid had reached Norway, reached New York, I won't bother, right?
No, then we'll stay at home, but no.
Yeah, it'll be boring, we'll stay
I
home.
Would really like to come, but, you know, otherwise engaged.
You know, just stay inside and play dominoes and chess.
Yep. Ah, shit, somebody actually got sick.
Who got sick?
Now, one of my courtiers has some sort of sickness.
Oh. You have to get the physician to do a dance.
Wow, my physician has a loyal parrot. That is awesome.
So, physicians, why do you have to appoint them? Why can't you just... I don't know, it feels like the process of getting a physician seems a little bit more complex than everything else. Why do you have to fire an event for a physician, but everything else just gets appointed?
You could just appoint someone, but this increases the chance of getting somebody good.
Right. How do you know if someone's a good or a bad physician, then?
They need to have a higher learning stat.
Okay, I didn't really click on him, so I don't actually know. We could have hired someone who was bad. Okay, so these days of rivalry are an excellent escape. So many laughs, so many... Revelry, not rivalry. Intense conversations in short time. It brings you closer to your companions. You feel like good friends already. Duke, become close friends. You and the Duke become close, okay. You have arrived in the private...
you know the King of Scotland?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, he kind of died again.
What?
There was an accident. The bow went off. I was cleaning the bow, and he was hit. And it was horrible. But I just got an event from it. It says, "Haha! He who laughs last laughs longest." Finally, that foul tadpole, King Duncan II, has left this fine earth. While everything will definitely be better without him, I have a lot of extra time on my hands now, ... And then the top pick is, I do think Duncan's skull would look fine on my mantelpiece. No. Attempt to steal the head of Duncan II from his grave.
What would you gain from that?
I don't know, but I have to click it. Right? I have to click that. Shit, okay. I wonder if I can get his skull. That would be awesome.
You've arrived in the private rooms of Court Jerbod. There is plenty of food and drink here. Your mood is delightfully merry. You are looking forward to this. Let's get started. Increased prestige. Rivalry and carousing is over for now. Time to get back to real life. It was fun. Gives extra prestige. What are you laughing at? Oh my god, what have you done?
Finally, with one last swing of the cleaver, King Duncan II's ugly head is severed from his equally disgusting body. He was 7 years old. I roll it up into a piece of cloth and stash it in my satchel and escape undetected into the night. I almost wish you were alive to see this, Duncan. Count Olaf of Northumberland gets Skull Trophy, giving him the following effects. Monthly prestige plus 0.05 monthly.
Okay. What's happening? Because they've raised levies.
Yes, something wonderful just happened.
Are they fighting for the throne then?
Yes, they are. This is exactly what I was hoping to accomplish, because now I've destabilized the Scottish Empire Scottish Kingdom to the point where there's a civil war now. So we can stab this Gospatric of Scottish Revolt in the back and try to take Cumberland from Matt from under him.
Okay, how do we do that?
Well, the first thing you need to do is you need to click on the... You see, in Scotland there are now two kingdoms with kind of the same color?
Yeah, so they represent who's on the throne and who's contesting it, right?
Exactly, and let's see what they're actually fighting for. They are... Oh, yeah, the guy who's revolting, he wants to institute elective monarchy instead of what they have now, which is primogeniture. So right now, the eldest son inherits. They want elective instead, where all the nobles elect one guy to rule after the previous guy's death. So wow, they want a quasi-democracy instead of hereditary rule.
Wow. Yep. That liberty in 1068.
Yeah, unacceptable. We need to stop this. This is insanity. So what you want to do now is you want to click Lothain. Is that how you pronounce it?
Well,
Lothain. It's the capital of the rebellion. The big red shield with the black stripes, black bars.
Lothian, yeah.
Yeah, Lothian. You need to click that, and then you need to click on Gospatric of Scottish Revolt.
Yeah.
That brings him up, and then you can right-click his face, and then declare war.
Whoa, are you going straight to war?
Yeah, why not?
He says, the Gospatric is currently revolting against his liege. If that conflict ends, our war will end too. The forces of the liege and any revolters will be hostile to our armies. De jure claim on Cumberland.
Yep.
And we're going to send it.
Yep.
Are you sure?
We'll see.
Well, you've got dudes.
I've got my little army raised. So next time, we're going to teach Dave from Feedback Gaming how to fight a war in Crusader Kings 2.
What? What's the time we're at right now?
We're at 24 minutes, my friend. We're not going to win in 5 minutes.
Oh, okay.
It's called fair a cliffhanger. We'll get him to watch the next episode.
It's so tense.
Yes. Can you feel... Guys. You can cut it with a knife.
We are done and over now. Any last words, Alex?
No, I think the King of Scotland said it best when it said, yeah.
And then you run off with his head.
The 7-year-old boy king's head. I have it on my mantelpiece and I take shots from it. Anyway.
You get some sick pleasure from being this evil.
Stuff happens. It's the Middle Ages. The world's too cruel for young children. Anyway, we'll see you guys around. Thanks for joining me, Dave.
Everyone.
Cheers.
Bye-bye.